Hello and welcome to Answering ATPL. This video will discuss direct reading compass, or sometimes referred to as direct indicating compass or standby compass, as part of ASA ATPL General Navigation subject. This video is divided into three sections. Section 1, the direct reading compass. Section 2, direct reading compass requirements. And Section 3, direct reading compass error. This video will not cover deviation since I already covered that topic in my previous video titled Direction 2, Direction Component. You can find the link to the video in the top right hand corner of the screen. Section 1, the direct reading compass. A direct reading compass consists of a freely suspended magnet that aligns itself with the horizontal component of the Earth's magnetic field, which defines the direction of magnetic north. By aligning the compass card with the north-seeking end of the magnet, the aircraft magnetic heading can be read off against a lubber line. Direct reading compass usually is centrally mounted on top of the instrument panel away from most aircraft magnetic and electrical influences, where both pilots can read it. A direct reading compass usually acts as a master heading reference for light aircraft and as a standby in larger aircraft. Since the direct reading compass does not require any external power to operate other than its lighting, a direct reading compass is a fail-proof system that is almost impossible to fail. According to ASA Generic Master Minimum Equipment List, CSGEN MMEL, at least one magnetic compass need to be serviceable for an aircraft to be deemed airworthy. Before each flight, the flight crew must conduct a serviceability test on the direct reading compass. The serviceability test consists of checking direct reading compass general condition and its accuracy. Compass accuracy is usually checked during lineup against published runway magnetic heading. According to CS Ops 1, magnetic compass accuracy limit must be within plus minus 10 degree. For the example on screen, the runway heading is 360 degree magnetic. Compass indication must be within 350 degree to 010 degree for it to be considered serviceable. Direct reading compass accuracy may also be checked against other compass systems such as radio magnetic indicator RMI. Nowadays, most aircraft use E-type compass. Although other types of compass are still in service, for ATPL examination, you only require to know about E-type compass. The E-type compass consists of a circular compass card attached directly to the magnetic assembly, suspended in lubricating fluid within a compass bowl. The magnetic assembly is pendulously suspended on a fixed pivot point. Due to the nature of fluid that expand and contract with temperature variation, an expansion valve is incorporated in the design. A vertical lubber line on a glass window in the compass casing enables the heading to be read against the compass card. The principle of the direct reading compass is similar to any other magnetic compass. It is important to remember that the suspended sensing system is the reference. Ideally, the vertical compass card on the sensing system stays stationary. It is the instrument casing that rotate about the magnet system and the vertical compass card. Section 2, Direct Reading Compass Requirement. To serve its purpose, a direct reading compass must possess three basic properties: horizontality, sensitivity, and aperiodicity. Let's look at each one of them in turn. Horizontality. Freely suspended in the Earth's magnetic field, a magnet system will align itself with the direction of that field. At the magnetic equator, or also known as the acrylic line, the field direction is parallel to the Earth's surface. At all other places, the magnet system is tilted in the direction of total field T, where T is the resultant of the horizontal and vertical field. Please note that the magnetic equator is not co-located with geographic equator. If the magnet system were allowed to align itself with the T field, it will reduce the magnetic moment in the horizontal plane in which direction is measured. Moment is a measure of a body tendency to rotate about a specific point or axis. Moment is the product of force multiplied by distance. To help you understand this concept, I have prepared an animation. Let's say we take a magnet bar and fix it to a pivot. As the magnet tilt, the distance from the magnet bar north tip to the pivot point decrease, reducing the moment. The lower the moment, the lower the magnet system ability to align itself to the Earth's magnetic field, thus reducing its sensitivity and accuracy. By the way, don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell icon to get notified when I publish a new content. A pendulous suspension system is therefore used to reduce the magnet system tendency to tilt. When the pendulously suspended magnet system tilts to align with T, the magnet system center of gravity is displaced from the vertical. The magnet system weight forms the couple WD, which acts opposite to the ZD couple produced by the vertical component and restore the magnet system to near horizontal. This solution only reduces the tilt effect and not eliminating it completely. A well-designed compass has a residual tilt of approximately plus minus 2 degrees. Sensitivity. For the second requirement, a direct reading compass must be sensitive and able to indicate the local magnetic meridian quickly and accurately. The following method may increase sensitivity: increasing the magnetic moment of the magnet system, reducing the moment of inertia of the magnet system, reducing the friction at the pivot point. To increase the magnetic moment, we can use a large, powerful magnet. However, a large magnet is heavy and will increase the moment of inertia. A compromise is needed between the magnetic moment and the moment of inertia requirement. By using several small, light, and powerful magnets as the magnetic sensing element of the compass, a compromise is reached. Friction at the pivot is reduced by using an iridium tip pivot and jewel cup. Friction is further reduced by suspending the magnet system in a lubrication fluid. Buoyancy produced by the fluid reduces the weight of magnet assembly acting on the pivot. Furthermore, the fluid provides lubrication to the bearing and further reduces its friction. Aperiodicity. Aperiodicity measures how quickly the magnetic compass settles down to accurately point north again after being displaced. Aperiodicity is achieved using a magnet system with a low moment of inertia and high magnetic moment. The same compromise applied for sensitivity. Aperiodicity also improved by filling the compass bowl with lubricating fluid. The fluid acts as a damping agent to improve aperiodicity. Some of you might ask, why the compass card turned with the aircraft? This phenomenon happened due to turning error and liquid swirl. We will discuss turning error later in the video. Liquid swirl happened due to the fluid viscosity. It tends to stick to the compass casing and compass card. Thus, when aircraft is turning, the lubrication fluid will turn with the aircraft and drag the compass card along. Section 3. Direct reading compass errors. Errors associated with direct reading compass are parallax error, liquid swirl, acceleration error, scale error, turning error, alignment error, and deviation. For general navigation subject, we only need to understand liquid swirl, acceleration error, turning error, and deviation. In this section, I will focus only on acceleration error and turning error. Liquid swirl will be explained with turning error. As mentioned before, for deviation, please watch my previous video titled Direction 2. Link is in the video description. Acceleration error. Acceleration errors occur when aircraft is positioned away from magnetic equator and when accelerating in easterly and westerly direction. Acceleration error happens due to magnetic dip. The greater the distance of the compass from magnetic equator, the greater is the angle of dip. Magnetic dip causes the center of gravity to be displaced to the equator side of the pivot. When aircraft accelerate, the action force acts on the pivot while the reaction force acts on the center of gravity. Reaction force and the distance of center of gravity produce a turning moment which turn the magnet sensing system and produce an accurate compass reading. The turning of the magnet sensing system create an illusion that the aircraft is turning while accelerating. The opposite happens when aircraft decelerate. The table on the screen lists the effect of acceleration error. Turning error. The root cause of turning error is the same as the acceleration error described before, namely that the center of gravity of the magnet system is displaced to the equator side of the pivot. Turning errors are observed to be most pronounced during turn through north and south. When an aircraft turns, action force is acted toward the center of the turn. Since the direct reading compass center of gravity is displaced from its pivot, the reaction force will act on the CG away from the center of turn. Moment produced by R and D turn the magnet. While an aircraft in northern hemisphere is turning through north, turning error will cause the compass indication to lag. While still in northern hemisphere, aircraft turn through south, turning error will cause the compass indication to lead. Turning errors are generally more significant than acceleration errors due to the following reason. Turns are generally of a greater magnitude, which result in a greater displacement of the magnet assembly. Turns occur more often and likely to last longer than linear acceleration. How does liquid swirl affect turning errors? When an aircraft turns, the liquid turns in the same direction as the aircraft. When the compass card is turning in the same direction as the aircraft, the swirl will add to the turning error. When the compass card is turning in the opposite direction to the aircraft, the swirl will reduce the turning error. To understand this concept, let's look at a couple of examples. In Northern Hemisphere, an aircraft is turning from 045 degree to 315 degree. The direction of turn is counterclockwise. Due to the displacement of center of gravity, action force acts on pivot while reactionary force acts on the center of gravity, which creates turning error that causes the magnet and the compass card to rotate counterclockwise. The compass card is turning in the same direction as the aircraft. Swirl exaggerates the turning error. In the second scenario, in Northern Hemisphere, an aircraft is turning from 225 degree to 135 degree. The aircraft turns counterclockwise. The turning error causes the magnet and compass card to rotate clockwise. The compass card is turning in the opposite direction to the aircraft. The swirl reduces the turning error. The table on the screen summarizes turning errors and the effect of liquid swirl. For your examination, you do not have to memorize this table or the table for acceleration error. Just memorize these four sentences. When accelerating on east or west direction, compass indicate a turn toward nearer pole. When decelerating on east or west direction, compass indicates a turn toward further pole. Turning through nearer pole, compass reading lag and swirl increase turning error. Turning through further pole, compass reading lead and swirl decrease turning error. These sentences apply to both the North and South Hemisphere. What do you think of this video? Please let me know in the comment section below. And if you find the video beneficial, please like it and share with others. By doing so, you will help other people to find the video. If you want to learn more about ATPL or other aviation related stuff, subscribe now by clicking on the round subscribe icon. Please check out my other video by clicking on the rectangular box. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.